Hi all, welcome to PowerShell for Penetration Testers at Pentester Academy. In this video, let's have a look at jobs in PowerShell. Jobs in PowerShell are a way to execute commands and scripts, etc. in background. Jobs are based much on the PowerShell remoting infrastructure. So let's first have a look at local jobs and then remote jobs. As always, because we are starting something new, let's go to the help system and what it has to offer for job. So there are many commandlets. Let's use get command. Again, some commandlets. The interesting ones being start job, etc. So let's use start job to execute a simple native command as job. As you can see that the job has been executed. Now we can use the get job parameter. It supports ID, name, etc. to get the object of that job. And if we run get job without any parameter, it returns all the jobs. To receive the output, we can use the receive job commandlet. And here is the output of this job. Now, since the job is complete, we can use the remove job commandlet to remove this job. Now, if we run get job, nothing is returned. Start job also accepts file path as a parameter. Let's just simply run our hello world script as a job, and now if we receive its output, it's hello world. So this was a very quick way or quick look at local jobs. You can always explore jobs much more. They are interesting and very useful. Of course, you can also start multiple jobs. For example, using a for each loop on a collection of objects. We will see this in detail when we discuss egress testing using PowerShell. There we will use these jobs, and we will have a job listening on every port on a listener machine, and from our target another PowerShell script connects back to our listener machine and thus reporting the outbound ports allowed from the target. That we will see later on. Now let's move on to remote jobs. One way of running commands or scripts remotely is to use commandlets which support the sjob parameter. Let's not look into the WMI ones right now. Invoke command, which we have been using thoroughly, supports as job. So let's now focus on the remote jobs. Let's try running PS, which is an alias to get process, on domain PC. Now this was a dry run. Now let's use the start job here. As you can see that in the script block of invoke command, we're passing a start job commandlet. Now a very interesting thing here is we see that the job has been executed on localhost. Let's list the job, but this job and this job are different. Why so? Because this job has been executed on domain PC. Here localhost means domain PC, because the job has been executed there. But how do we receive the output from that job? If we run get job now, there is nothing to see, because we came across this problem earlier, because the commands run by invoke command are stateless. And recall, how did we solve that? We use the new PS session parameter commandlet to create a session and execute things under this session. Let's, like earlier, let's catch this into a sess variable. And now let's just use the earlier one. Now we are passing a session parameter to the same command which we used earlier. The job has been executed. Now let's run get job. Yes, there is a job which has been completed. Let's pass receive job and we can see the output. So this is an example where a job was executed on a remote machine and the result was preserved there. Now to save all this thing, we can use the sjob parameter which we saw a couple of minutes back. As you can see that we are reusing our old invoke command commandlet and just pass the sjob parameter. So there is no need to run the job here. Now if we run the get job, you can see that the job location is domain PC, but it is available locally. Same goes for this earlier job which we executed. Now if we see the output of this job, it is exactly what we expected. So I think that is enough for remote jobs. As an exercise, run jobs in a persistent PS session. PS session is persistent anyway. So in a PS session, play with it. Everything which we saw for local jobs applies for a job or PS session. You can run jobs in a PS session like you are doing it locally, and the lifetime of the jobs would be the lifetime of the PS would be equal to the lifetime of the PS session. As soon as you exit the PS session, the jobs would be interrupted. So that is all for this video. If you are enjoying your time at Pentester Academy, please recommend us to your friends and colleagues in the information security community.